I'm really scared.
Absolute pleasure of knowing in my life. And if you look around here in front of family, friends, and Jose, you can see how much love is really here with everyone. And in my long 30 years of life, I've seen a lot of different types of love. I've seen passionate love that doesn't necessarily last. I've seen possessive love that cuts people off, and I've seen bickering love that is always fighting. And it's few and far between that you can find the love that Kelly and Nick share. The kind of love that has all of it, really, that encapsulates, thank you, my English, the entire spectrum. And if you spend more than just an hour with them, it's clear that really they have it all. They have enough to go the distance. I've often said that love is not just about finding someone cute or fun. It's seeing all of someone, not just what makes them like awesome, but also like seeing the flaws in someone else and accepting their flaws. And let me tell you, if Nick can handle Kelly's very extreme personalities, and Kelly can handle Nick's stubborn Taurus energy, I really think that they can handle everything that life is going to throw at them. And they really can. Living with them has shown me a unique window into their life. I'm blessed to see that even when they're extremely mad at each other, they choose love. They choose each other always. When they're mad, they even tell each other that they love each other. When they're fighting, they choose to like kiss each other and tell each other that though they're mad, they really do still have that feeling of love for each other. Under every single emotion that they have, there's an undeniable love, a real love that I hope to find in some fraction in a relationship that I'll find in my life. You know, I've known that this moment has been coming for a really long time. Nick told me about 3 years ago on my birthday, he took me out, that he was going to propose to Kelly. He took me out for pancakes, which I was really excited about because I think pancakes are the best breakfast food. It wasn't until halfway through the meal that Nick told me he hates pancakes, which was a little bit of a red flag, but I ignored, that he was going to propose to Kelly. And I was a little overwhelmed, didn't have a lot of words that I told to you in that moment, but really all of the overwhelming feelings were of love and excitement. There was not a single thing that I was thinking was going to be a red flag, aside from the pancakes, and hold anything back. There was nothing but excitement, and I just really wanted this moment to happen. And here we are. So through a bunch of things, through Nick's less than ideal hairstyles and a broken door or two, we've made it. But this really is only the beginning. This is the beginning of a beautiful family that you guys are going to create, and I'm a lifelong subscriber of the Miola saga. Sorry, Nick, it's the Miola saga, but I'm a lifelong subscriber of what's to come. And with that said, I think that the bride and groom have prepared some words to say to each other. And we're going to start with Kelly.
Really? I love you so much. I'm so happy. I can't wait to marry you.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's it? I love it. She said we weren't going to do this, so I didn't prepare until like an hour ago. Everyone knows I've been super stressed the whole day.
I agree.
I'm so excited to be here, babe. I'm so devoted to you, and I can't wait to start our life. I love you.
Can I get the ring?
Got him.
Okay, so for the vows, repeat after me. I, Nicholas Aristizabal.
I, Nicholas Aristizabal.
Take thee, Kelly.
Take what?
Take you, Kelly Miola.
Take you, Kelly Miola.
As my happily wedded wife.
As my happily wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer. Richer.
Till death. Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
I, Kelly Miola.
I, Kelly Miola.
Take thee, Nicholas Aristizabal.
Take thee, Nicholas Aristizabal.
In happily matrimony.
In happily
matrimony.
You said something wrong there. In happiness and matrimony.
In sickness and in health.
In virtue or for poor.
Till death to
his part.
Oh, jeez.
All right.
Oh, you got it.
So you guys have had several kisses before, but this is going to be a kiss that's different. You guys are officially married for the rest of your life.
I feel good. Make some noise as we welcome this bridal party. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Stephen and Michael. Come on, come on, make some noise, make some noise. All right, we're gonna continue. Please continue making some noise for Alejandra and Diego alongside the ring bearer, Emiliano. Come on, put your hands up, put your hands up. Your maid of honor, give it up for Diana and Jose. And now I need everybody to please get up on your feet, continue making some noise. So you make some noise and celebrate for the reason why we're here today. Make some crazy noise for your bride and groom, Kelly and Nicolet! Yes! Awesome! All right, and at this time, we're gonna ask Kelly and Nick to please work your way to the center of the dance floor for your first dance.
Well, say, only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with.
Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Now at this time, we're gonna ask everybody to please kindly take your seats as we prepare for the best man and the maid of honor to give you their toast.
All right, guys. So I'm gonna be brutally honest. I'm horrible.
Ooh. Okay.
Hello, everybody. There comes a time in everyone's life when they meet their one true love, their soulmate, the person that's going to know and love them for the rest of their lives. That moment came for Nick 10 years ago when he met me in high school, if I'm being honest. llega un punto en la vida de todos cuando encontramos un único amor, la alma gemela, la persona que vamos a conocer por el resto de nuestras vidas. Y ese momento lo llevó a Nicolás 10 años atrás cuando me conoció a mí en la secundaria. Abuelita, perdóneme, pero el resto va a ser en inglés. Abuelita, I'm sorry, the rest is going to be in English. Good evening, everybody. On behalf of the newlyweds, I would like to thank everybody for attending this amazing celebration. Everyone looks lovely today, if I'm being honest. Despite the rain, you know, the sun is out, you know, and you know, I heard that when it rains on your wedding, that's supposed to be good luck. So we're starting off on the right foot, you know. Before I get started tonight, I want to go over. I had a list, guys. I had a list. These people, they didn't want me going over a lot of subjects today. But they wanted me to avoid some topics. I'm gonna start off with, where in the world is my piece of paper? I don't know where it's at. I'm gonna start with. I had Michael assist me with this one, and he started writing, you know, a nice paragraph for me. At first, he wrote for me. Nick is really the best friend I've ever had. He's done so many wonderful things that it would be difficult for me to name them all. And to be quite honest, he started naming them down, and I just couldn't read his handwriting, so this is why I'm all nervous in front of you guys. But seriously, it's all true. If I'm being honest, I've always looked up to Nick. He's the almost the perfect and rarely makes any mistakes. due to that trait, I'll say it this one time, okay? Nick is almost perfect and rarely makes any mistakes. Due to that, I had a hard time coming up with material for this speech, you know? And he has been for there. Nick is the most loyal and genuine person that I've ever met. He's been there for me countless times. He has stuck by my side through thick and thin. And he's been in moments and situations that I assure you guys wouldn't want to be by my side then. Wow, I'm messing up good. I'm going off, but whatever. Yeah, no. Wait up. I'm gonna just bring it down to this. I'm very excited and I'm very honored to stand by his side today. He's a true gentleman that I would love to take my last breath on this earth. I know he will be a fantastic husband, and when the time comes, he will be a fantastic father. I'm very certain. I'm certain he will always be there for Kelly and everyone in their family. And my dearest Kelly, you look radiant today. I'm overwhelmed with your joy that you chose Nick to be your lifetime partner. You know, he's a good guy. In my opinion, he's the best person that you can have by your side. And I'm so happy you two found each other today. Not only have you become an irreplaceable friend, but today I have gained a sister. Kelly, thank you for rescuing me when I needed dressing advice. Thank you. Well, you know, thank you for rescuing me, but thank you for rescuing Nick with his quote-unquote fashion choices, you know. So, you're the best. You really are. You two are the best friends I could ever wish for. And moving, you guys, yeah, this is an unconditional friendship. You two guys are the, and more importantly, you're the best together.
Female public speaking in college. All right, give him a round of applause.
He rescued me, and I almost put this into the speech. He rescued me in front of our law class multiple times. So, thank you.
Give it up for Jose, your best man.
I'm drinking a vodka soda because, hello, bride, this is her drink. This is our drink. I'm not prepared for this, but here we go. Kelly, I love you so much. I'm so happy for this moment and this day. And Nicholas, she couldn't find anyone better than you. I met Kelly about 11 years ago, and one random night in the summer, and an old friend said, we're gonna go pick up this girl, Kelly. And I was like, okay, cool, more the merrier, let's go. We're going to Atlantic City. And true story. I was probably, I don't know, don't remember. I was told I was dancing in the pool. I don't know, Atlantic City, Harrah's, shit happens. But I woke up drenched, soaking wet, and I walk into the bathroom and there was my best friend around the toilet. And I said, that's her. That's the one. And I never looked back. She was wrapped around the toilet sleeping because that's where she was comfortable. And I just said, do you, girl. I'm just gonna squat really quick and then I'm gonna go, but you can stay there. And then the next morning, she lost her phone. And I'm thinking, shoot, we go to T-Mobile. Or AT&T. I don't know. We go somewhere. It was 11 years ago. You think I remember? And all I remember was thinking to myself, this girl's about to buy a brand new iPhone. Damn, that bitch is rich. I still think she's rich to this day. But that's her business. And ever since then, we never separated. We've traveled together. We've literally done everything together. And she has looked out for me. I've had some bad days. I've had some low points in my life. I'm not gonna cry, but she's always stuck by my side. And I couldn't have a better friend than Kelly Miola. And Kelly knows what I'm talking about. And she it's not like that. She knows what I'm talking about. And she knows that her friendship means so much to me. And she's like my other sister. I have a sister who lives in another state. But Kelly's here. She's with me. And I get to see her more than I see my sister. And so I consider her family. And she's been nothing but a wonderful person to my family. And I'm just so honored, I'm so blessed to have these two beautiful, amazing human beings in my life who look out for me every single day. I call them mom and dad. And I call them mom and dad because they are just so wonderful to me. And I am so happy that we're here. We started from the bottom, but we're here. And I wish I had a picture of Kelly starting from the bottom, but I don't have a projector, but she knows what I'm talking about, and she don't want that picture out anyways. But we start from the bottom over here, and I just want to say I love you both so much, and congratulations to many memories, love, happiness, and health, and cheers, baby, cheers.
All right, give it up one more time for your maid of honor, Deanna. Okay, and at this time, we're gonna go ahead and open up the dance floor while dinner is being served.
llega al baile, llama la atención. Tiene el escenario, ella se roba el show, baila con su estilo como un pibe.